now we're going to do the sequence to where we'll do cat-cow. I'll go into child's pose, go down into a low push-up, upper dog, downward dog, and kind of go through that sequence. And you can do that as many times as you want. So first kind of way down on your knees. Make sure that your wrists are stacked with your shoulders and your shoulder width apart, knees hip width apart, and this kitty cat here, I'm going to go down, arch up, exhale, stretch, one, mascot here. Thank you for coming. It's a really good structure in the back. And I can actually feel it in my tummy right now. I should do that a few more times, but by the length of the video, I'm going to go down into those, the bottom are on my feet. I'm stretching my wrist out. And then I'm going to go up to upper dog. Feet still hip width apart. And right now I'm stacked over my wrist. I want to make sure that my fingers are nice and spread. And I'm raising my butt, trying to keep my back straight. Pushing back and lowering my heels. Lowering my head, wrist, making an adjust. With that, take some breaths. And forward, lower down, upward. And a nice deep stretch. Toes, push up to them. And again, we'll just make an adjustment. If you can bring your heels down, that's good. If not, it's okay to be up. Little push up. And flip your feet. And then downward facing dog. This is why those tight yoga shirts work good, so your belly doesn't hang out. I'd show it all now, and hopefully in a few months I won't have a belly hanging out so much. And then notice that my feet are too wide, so you can always make it just. Up the front of your mat, fall down, up, up, and put your hands on your knees, straight back, sit. All right, try to do that hopefully at least 10, a sequence of 10.